So to work through this, I just made it a different example. We're going to convert the previous equation, so the one we just worked with in orange there, or in red, to slope-intercept form, which is what I've shown you in green, and then I'm going to show you slope-point form shortly as well. For slope-intercept form, I start by writing the equation, and slope-intercept form is y equals mx plus b. The y is isolated, so we're going to isolate that y. It's negative 2y, so I have to add 2y to both sides to cancel them out. I'm left with 4x plus 2 is equal to 2y. To make it look like y equals mx plus b, I just swap the positions. You don't have to if you don't want to, but it helps to visualize for some people like myself. Then I end up with 2y equals 4x plus 2. The last thing is I need to get y by itself, and the only way I can do that is divide both sides by 2. That takes a 2 out of y, and I'm left with y equals 2x plus 1. That is slope-intercept form. If you get to this form, you can graph from this to this if you wanted to. You end up with the exact same result, right? Remember, your b value at the end should be your y-intercept. Well, it is. And then you can solve for the other point by making y equal to 0. If y equals 0, 2x plus 1, 1 comes over, you get negative 1 equals 2x. Divide both sides by 2, negative 1 over 2 is equal to x. Same idea over here. So it works for slope-intercept as well. Okay, so for slope-point form, you need to have a point. So I'm just going to steal it from my previous table or previous set of values that we calculated before. You'll see that they all work hand in hand with each other. So y minus y1 is equal to m times x minus x1. Well, y is just y minus my y value, which was 1, so y minus 1, is equal to m times x minus my x value. My x value I chose was this point at 0, so you have x minus 0. And the last thing is slope. In this case, it was this m value, and it's a 2. Well, where does a 2 come from? Again, if you're converting, you can work between all of the equations. So I stole 2, actually, from this equation down over here, because just by looking at the equation, I know that my slope is equal to 2. So I'm just going to steal that slope, and that's where that number comes from. If you didn't know, then you would have to do the slope formula. M is equal to y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Thankfully, though, previously, you have two points to work with. So you can calculate what that slope is and then plug that into your equation.